Welcome, everybody. Welcome to Intensify Millionaire Institute. This is your channel where you learn how to achieve financial freedom, where you learn the principle of wealth creation. I want to talk today about money secret of the rich. Money secret of the rich. I want to share that information with you, and I strongly believe you are going to be transformed and your life can never be the same. What are the money secrets of the rich? We are going to spend time together, and I'm going to break everything down for those who are watching me. Don't forget to give us a like and hit the notification bell, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel on wealth creation. If you are watching me right now, I want to say congratulations unto you because you just picked the right channel. Get ready because your life is going to be transformed dramatically. Your life will change from zero to hero and from the bottom to the top. I want to let you know right now that the information you are about to receive have tested, have been proven over the years. Becoming a millionaire today is not a big deal. Actually, it's easy. So everyone who wants sincerely to become a millionaire can become a millionaire. This is the secret of the rich I want to share with you today. So what I'm about to share today, if you believe, your life will never be the same. And if you decide to put it into practice, something good is about to happen to you. So let me start by giving you some little statistics. I don't know if you are aware that 80% of the population of the world are living in less than $2. Let's say are living in less than $10 a day. This is very, very sad. 80% of the population is living in less than $10 a day. And 3 billion people right now, as I'm speaking to you, live on $2 a day. And 1 billion people live in less than $1 a day. So 5,000 people are dying daily because of poverty. So this is to let us to know that poverty is not a topic we're supposed to underestimate. We're supposed to take that topic seriously because people are dying, families are destroyed, kids found themselves into a lot of stuff because of poverty. So I'm going to give you right now some practical secrets that I strongly believe are going to help you, are going to help you to fix your life and fix your finances right away. So let's go deeply inside the subject. Let me dive deep with you. So if you allow me, we are going to see every secret right now, step by step. If you're watching me right now, this is a clear indication that you are trying to do something to change your life. You are trying to fight for your family, maybe. You are trying to fight for your wife or for your husband, or you are trying to fight for your kids, or you are trying to be the breadwinner of your whole family. So what I'm about to share with you right now are proven, tested principles that if you put them into practice, something good is about to happen to you. Now, you want to become a millionaire or you want to be wealthy. What are the secrets of the wealthy? What are the secrets of the wealthy? I want you to understand right away that rich people or successful people, they don't really believe in luck. They don't believe in luck. They believe in the principle of cause and effect. Successful people know that every success that's going to come in their life is going to be the product of hard work. People who are not successful, they rely on gambling and they rely on luck. That's why they miss it in life. That's why they don't achieve anything glorious. I want you to know also that real success is a lifetime of learning. The difference between the rich and the poor is very simple. Poor people prefer to watch TV, whereas rich people prefer to read books, to educate themselves, to train their mind, to learn before they earn. So for you to become successful or for you to become financially free, you need to reach a point in your life where you are going to condition your mind to learn from other people or from other people's failure and also successes. You need to be humble enough to ask questions to people who are doing well, ask them what they did to be where they are, be humble and keep on asking questions. If you refuse to ask questions, you refuse to be mentored, your life will not have so much fruit to show. Successful people are people who decide to learn something and they want to be good at it. They decide to take a skill and to develop their skill. on the daily basis? What are you doing with the skill that you have on you? Maybe you can sing, maybe you can dance, maybe you can write a book, maybe you can code very well. What are you doing to polish your gift? What are you doing to polish your talent? What are you doing to make your talent to shine? That's the question. So money is running away from you because you don't understand some simple principle of wealth creation. You know, it's very, very important for you to understand that your success will not come by luck. Your success will not come by ignorance. Nobody succeeds by ignorance. And nobody succeeds by chance. You know, everybody you see at the top right now, everybody you see ruling, everybody you see doing well, knows something that maybe you don't know. So instead of you complaining and trying to find fault or trying to play the victim or say, I'm poor because of the country, because of the economy, because of God, because of the devil, nobody loves me. It's time for you to take control of your life. It's time for you to take charge of your life. What can you do practically to change your life? What can you do practically to bring a plus in your life? What you need to put in you to be successful. Everybody can make money in life. Everybody can have success. Everybody who really desire to be successful can be successful. So right now, I'm going to speak about one principle only. And I'm going to be keep on coming daily to bring new principles. So I'm going to be talking about saving right now. How it is important for you to save. How it's so important for you to build that habit of saving. So let us start right away. Okay, let's go. In order for you to make money on earth, or in order for you to be financially free, you need to understand the principle of saving. When I speak about the principle of saving, I'm talking about you having the wisdom that each time you get a paycheck or you receive money, you learn how to pay yourself also. Learn to pay yourself first. Learn to remove at least 10% of every money you are receiving. You keep it aside in order to invest in the future. That's very, very, very important. If you don't know how to save money or you have a problem with saving money, you can instruct your bank to automatically transfer funds directly to the account you're supposed to save your money. If you have a problem, you can call that account, for example, pay myself accounts, for example, or financial freedom account. That account, every time you receive your paycheck or your salary, you transfer at least 10% to 20%, it's up to you, of your money into that account. And that account, you don't touch that money. You are saving that money in order to wait for an opportunity and invest. So you are not saving that money to use it. You are not saving that money to eat it. You are saving that money in order to invest. That's very, very important to get, and that's very, very important to understand. So when you have your money, 100% of your money, 10 to 30% of that money, you should store it somewhere. You should save it somewhere. Refuse to eat 100% of every money you are making. If you make $10,000 a month, $1,000 to $3,000, you're supposed to save it somewhere. If you're living in Philippines and you make 30,000 pesos a month, $1,000 to $3,000, you're supposed to save it somewhere to secure your future. It's very, very, very important. At least 3,000 pesos you're supposed to save, or 6,000 pesos or 9,000 pesos according to the money you are making. So if you're making 10,000, you know what to save. If you are making 30,000, you know what to save, 10 to 30% of your income. Now, if you receive money from people, for example, a friend gives you like 10,000 or 1,000, this kind of money, you're supposed to save between 80% to 90%. Because that kind of money is an extra income and it's not coming all the time. So as it's coming time to time, you're not supposed to eat a lot of it. You're supposed to save between 80 to 90% for this kind of money. So now, when you begin to put your money aside and you keep on saving that money, resolve in your heart not to touch that money and not to use it. because that money is to secure your future. That money is to wait for investment you are storing in order to invest. Now, some of you are telling me, I want to save money, but my salary is too small. I don't know how to save. You can also save money through economizing your spending. Try to reduce your spending also, because most of the time we have some spending habits that are taking money away from us. Expensive bills we are building in our lives. Too much internet, too much law, too much Wi-Fi, too much transportation, too much food, too much clothes, too much gadget, buying through impulses. We need to learn how to discipline our appetite. Some of us, we are losing money because we are passionate about food. We are passionate about sex. We are passionate about pleasure. We are passionate about clothes. We want the first class transportation. We want the expensive restaurant. We want to eat some Korean food. We want to go to the Chinese restaurant. We want to enjoy. We want to live good. It is okay to live good. It is okay to spoil yourself. But you need to spoil yourself when at least you have some passive income that can support your lifestyle. The question is, most of you love good stuff. You love good life. Do you have business to support your lifestyle? It's not enough to try to look rich. Don't look rich, be rich. Don't dress rich, be rich. Don't look like you have money. Don't dress like you have money. Make money in real life. That is the point. The point is not to impress. The point is not to look rich. The point is not to let the people to know on Facebook you have a lot of money. Begin to do stuff that are going to generate money in your life. Unless you do so, you are just fooling yourself. So it's time for you to focus in savings, save and think about investment. Build the culture of saving and also build the culture of investment. Keep some part of your earning for your future. That's why I say pay yourself first. And you can begin to increase what you are doing gradually. As God is blessing you and you're making more and more money, you can increase from 10% to 11%, to 11 to 12%, you save 20%, 22%, 30%. You can reach a point where you can save even 50%. For example, I speaking to you right now, I can save more than 50% of the money I'm making. How I do it? Very, very simple. I break my life into many departments. I try to understand what am I doing with my life. I know I need to travel for my vlogging. I need to travel for my YouTube channel. I know I need to travel to help some people as a part of my tradition and my culture, trying to do charity, give 10% of what I'm making back to the society. I know I like to swim. I like to go to resorts. I like to relax and refresh myself time to time. So when I know I like to do some good stuff, so what I did is that I tried to build passive income, businesses, and activities that can support what I love to do. So I will not go into resort if I don't have a business that can cover this kind of expenses. I will not do so. So now I found myself having businesses that can cover my trips, that can cover my traveling vlogs, that can cover the salary I pay to people who are working for me, that can cover the people I want to help, stuff like this, and also allow me to take care of myself. And I realized that I still have a lot of money left after all the spending. And I give the credit to the passive income I built around my life. So I want to encourage you as you are watching me to try to build your life around passive income. Your job is not enough to give you the kind of life you are hoping. That's why when you get your salary, remove a part, use it smartly, and think about a second business you can open, or a service you can open, or you can offer that can bring some extra cash in your life. I hope you are getting my point. For example, I'm sitting right now and I'm talking to you. At the same time, I have a lot of my books on Amazon. So I'm making some money through passive income. We have ebooks, We have paperback version, solid copy. We have the audio book, so people who don't like to read, they can listen. I have video program, I have audio program about wealth creation, success, motivation, spirituality. So I'm trying to make money even when I'm not working. From passive income, I just work once to produce that product or that course, and I can keep on making money on and on and on and on. Same with real estate. I suffer to own a place, to fix a place. And monthly, I keep on getting money from rental property. So I want you to think like that. I want you to think deep. Do something that can change your life and do something that can improve your life. Don't be hurried to invest. Take great caution. Take time to investigate before you put your money. People will come, they say they have a wonderful opportunity. Take your time. Take your time to check all the opportunities they are showing to you. Ask yourself the question, is it a legit business? Am I going to make some profit there? Is that company there for long term or short term? And when you put your money, watch over your money. As you make some money in return, don't fall into the trap of trying to live large or trying to enjoy thinking that because you are making money in 2019 or 2020, you are going to keep on making money. No. The law of conservation says it's not how much money you make that's going to determine your financial future. It is how much money you keep and how much money you invest. So how much are you keeping right now? And how much are you investing right now? That's why you need to be disciplined. Live below your means and live your life according to your purpose. Don't try to impress. And I'm insisting because this is the biggest trap from a lot of you. Try to analyze your priority from today and discipline yourself to save and to invest. And you are going to achieve financial freedom. Learn to develop a budget and live within your budget. Live by your budget, because a budget will define your priority. A budget is very, very important. It's going to define your priority. Budget is going to help you to stay disciplined and stay within what you plan to spend during the month of May or the month of April. By doing so, you are going to accumulate wealth, small amount, and then larger amount will keep on coming. They call that principle the law of accumulation. So it's time for you to define your goal very well and take action and move towards your goal. You are going to see how great success is going to come to you, and your life will never be the same. I hope you enjoyed this short session and you enjoyed the advice we just shared with you. If that's the case, I want you to give us a like, subscribe to our channel. We are going to keep on coming and bring to you wonderful information that will change your life. Thanks for your time. I love you all and see you soon.